Nigel Thornberry. And here we can spot the endangered medical snakes. It's very slow and very well dressed. So hopefully we'll find it around here somewhere. But perhaps not. Anyways, cheerio, have a wonderful day.
Kenya, what do you think they're doing?
I think they're taking photographs.
What's your name and your age in the picture?
Okay, so the wind turns now, 10, 9, 8, when I get to 0, ticker buttons are coming out, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, go ahead and put the pens back in the box and hand me the box. There's an orange one under the ninja's sheet, there you go. Okay. He just had a brownie and a glass of milk. Boop, and you feel full now. Was it good? No, it's all clean. All right, hand me the coloring. Thanks. Hand me the felt pens. Go ahead. Close it. I got it. Now everyone, stand up and hold your picture. Everyone, stand up and hold your picture and show it, because the best picture wins a trip to Disney World. Now, look at the audience, show you the picture in the audience. All right, everyone stand up. You too, Ruby, okay? All right, wow. All right, everyone take a look at the pictures. Hold your pictures up, show the audience. What do you think? Round of applause, you like them? Woo! You know what? I can't decide which one is best. Maybe nobody should win. That's a great idea. Everyone gets to go to Disney World. Have a seat. Go grab a seat. No, get out of her seat. So get your own seat. Oh, because I'm a bad person. Okay? Hold on to your picture. What's the matter? Okay, you sure?
That's not like what you tell me you're thinking.
Brain fart.
I want to go fishing.
Okay. Sleep.
Oh, God.
You'll hold on to your pictures. Even after you wake up from being hypnotized, you'll hold on to your pictures. You'll take the pictures home, and you'll keep it on your refrigerator for the next 2 weeks to show all your friends the great time you had at the show. The young lady who I'm touching on the shoulder right now, when you wake up, you just went on a deep-sea fishing trip. You caught 3 great white sharks with your bamboo fishing pole, and you rode a whale. And you had a great time. Everyone else is just going to wake up. But you're going to want to brag about your great fishing trip and tell everyone about it. 1, 2, 3, open your eyes. Hey, what's up? What'd you do?
I went to the big boat that goes in the ocean. You know, I think it's in New Hampshire or something.
Sure.
What?
Well, no, I think it's close to my house. I think. Well, I mean, I live
Patience.
My name is Patience.
Tressa, so hard. Okay. Hello, bachelors and bachelorette. Can you give the audience a big hello?
Hello.
Hi.
Hi. Hi. Hello. Hi. This is to make sure the mics work.
Hello.
Okay, good.
They do work. They need to be.
They all work. Everything is good. Everyone's good. But it's got to be close.
Put them closer to their nose.
Okay. Thank you. Are we whispering? Can the audience not hear us right now? Is that what's happening?
No. No, I can't hear it.
All right. Discuss. Are you ready to ask some questions?
I mean, if I have to.
You do.
I'm really not going to enjoy this at all.
You will. It'll be fun.
Don't you have somewhere else you can, like, be away from me? Like, let me control the board for once.
Okay, she needs space. We all need space. Be positive. Everything's fine.
Go, like, find sadness and, like, take care of her or something. Like, she needs it more than I do.
Don't be mean to sadness. She tries her best.
All right. So, I guess if I have to, bachelor or et number one?
Yeah, I'm right here, babe. What's up?
God, I can't believe this is gonna happen.
Of course, I mean, I watch it every night after school. I have a social life, I don't spend a lot of time on Netflix.
Oh god, you're like in school?
Yes. No, you're not into that? No, I'm not.
How old are you?
Be nice!
So anyway, if you could, like, marathon one show on Netflix, I guess, what would you marathon?
Oh my god, Golden Girls.
Gross. I'm not watching either of those with you.
I'll
watch. Can you think something better?
I'll watch.
I mean, that's a better answer. But you still have work to do to you know, get in my good graces. Bachelor or bachelorette number two? Yes? Huh. Alright, this is actually, I like this question, you know, just a little bit. What is the most gross food that you actually like?
Oh god.
But keep in mind that I'm still judging you on your answer.
I am a girth.
That's not very fair.
I am a girth.
My name's not fair.
Fair's not an emotion, so I hope not.
We got some sass.
God, Joy, let the person answer.
Okay, so.
Probably french fries mixed in milkshakes.
Do an oven.
Right? Perfect. That's perfect. That'd be really gross.
It's a disgusting choice you made. That's your opinion?
That is a disgusting choice. I kind of disgustingly enjoy that. Better answer. Okay. Bachelor or bachelorette number three. How do you handle awkward situations?
Completely avoiding them. Most of the time I just shut myself into my room and just start writing out all my emotions through romance novels.
Okay. I like that you get in touch with your emotions. I don't like romance novels.
But there's romance novels are the best kind of novels that you're ever going to pick up. Oh, the emotions that they can bring out.
I don't think that you and I get the same emotion from romance novels. Bachelor or bachelorette number one.
Still here. Story.
You haven't left yet?
I'll never leave. You're disgusting, so I hope you would.
Oh.
Be nice.
I mean, that's kind of okay. So, I have to know how disgusting you are. How often do you shower?
Is that seriously your question? Like,
I can't be with a disgusting person except on the inside. They can't be disgusting on the outside.
No, I'm not.
Are they like disgusting flowers?
Do you want them to be disgusting?
Yes.
Then they are disgusting.
Okay, then I like disgusting flowers.
Great.
Whatever. What is your most gross habit?
There are often times where I'll forget to shower and eat and drink for a few days at a time and forget to sleep.
Honey, that's called a convention.
I think the audience and I agree
Not that much.
I mean, you're both kind of, but I kind of choose Bachelor number 3. Yeah. It just never be. It ends badly. Watch it.
You'll never be.
Waking up,
So let's get day two underway, shall we?
Long monologue that Luke Valentine gives to Alucard, like,
oh,
darker than the blackest night. No, I am a demigod.
Oh, cut to camera. He's not actually a demigod. He's about to find out why. Fish, what were some of your favorite lines?
Well, ones that I've said, or like, just
in general.
One of my favorite lines is in episode 2 where, I forget, who's the one that
Yon
plays? Yon. Oh, Yon Valentine.
Literally, Yon.
Everything Yon says is my favorite line. My super favorite is when they go up there and it's like, oh, what are you guys doing here for? Oh, we're from a field trip. It's like, oh, cool, where are you guys from? And then the bus shows up and guns are just out there like, Texas!
I thought we had to pick our own characters. Shit!
No, it's free-balling. Everyone's
just if I get to pick any...
The original joke of that was Detroit, too. I mean... And Kaiser said it was racist.
Anyone can use a gun. Come on. Anyone can murder.
If I had to choose... Like, I thought I had to choose my own character. No.
You can just pick whatever for your favorite line is.
Oh, okay, because I was like, Luke Valentine's a total bitch. It would probably have to be one of the lines that we wrote, which was, here's what you do. You go down to the local corner store, you ask for something called Viagra, and then you go yourself!
For me, I love the entirety of episode 3. Like, beginning to end. The telephone scene with Alucard in the hotel. is the greatest thing I will ever write. I have accepted it. It's all downhill from there. I wrote this 8 months before we got to the episode, and I remember this, and I told Kaiser that, and like, we're doing this scene. Everything else can come together around it. I don't know. Just this scene.
Hey, how's it going? Oh, I know why you're angry. It's because I went to Brazil.
There's something so fun just about him not caring. It's the scene, because the thing with Alucard is, for those who don't know, the actual anime, he can't die technically because what he's doing is he's hashtag life hacking real life, and that he's absorbing souls. So he actually has like 3.5 million souls absorbed. So he can die 3.5 million times. That's all he needs to do. How he got that level of strength is he used to hang out in your battlefields during the Crusades, and it just absorbed the souls after a battle.
I'm just like, why doesn't everyone do it? Am I the only one?
You're trending.
I'm trending.
So technically, when he comes back later in the anime, he unleashes all the souls, and there's this giant army of like medieval Arabian people, and it's like terrifying, and it kills everybody. And I love Helsing. My favorite one is, real fast, the major speech at the end of episode 4. Lanny Couture did a fantastic job. Me and Scott had so much fun writing that, just for the Star Wars jokes. But overall, my favorite thing to say as Alucard is,
bitch, I eat people!
The final line, end it with this one, is,
have you heard the sensation sweeping the nation? At the same time,
bitches love cannons!
Quick question, did you finish?
Yeah, I did.
Okay, because that was the most masturbatory thing I've ever seen.
It's abso-frickin-lutely it was.
Oh man, I cannot wait for our 18th post panel.
Right?
7:20.
7:20. 9:30, right? No, Jesus.
Okay, so I got hooked up with Team Four Stars since they started Helsing Abridged. So, but since I've also watched the Abridged of DBZ, I want to ask Shenron this question though.
Who? Shenron isn't here actually.
Oh yeah, sorry. That's a shame.
Quick,
man.
Plan B.
That's how we'll get Lanny out here. Yeah, if you come with Shenron, it'd be good. Anyways, since he's not here, then Krillin's voice then.
Krillin's not here. Okay. For Piccolo, Vegeta, Krillin, Shenron, Arista Popo, they're not here.
Okay then. But here's something else though. Are you guys planning to see Resurrection F though?
Actually, yes we are. And I can't say how, but we're probably going to see it here very soon.
Yes.
Are we going to be seeing a bridge version of that movie?
Let's get through Cell first.
Let's get through Cell first, okay?
And then when we're done with Boo and putting our kids through college, we'll consider it.
Children, that's the best joke you've written so far.
Kaiser, you made your choice.
Listen to me.
I heard some great opposing opinions on certain things.
I'm just saying, I'm going to adopt the most beautiful little black girl, and I swear to God, no one's going to stop me.
Fine.
All right, Angel.
Too bad Brad couldn't come here.
Angelina,
Brad
Pitt, they adopted me. Sorry that Shenron's not here.
Your wish was not granted.
Wait, are you Data?